Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ, and today I'm going to talk about four reasons why the election won't cause the stock market to crash. If you follow news headlines every year going into an election, there's always a lot of gloom and doom, and it's no different when dealing with the stock market. Each and every time you have someone predicting that based on either the president staying or the president leaving, no matter which party they're a part of, that there's going to be a drop in the stock market and there's going to be some big change, whether in a negative or a positive way. Over the past three elections, I've personally witnessed it as an investor in the market. And I can tell you that most of the time, and based on these four points that I'm going to make in this video, that the election really doesn't matter that much as far as causing the market to crash. And so here are the four reasons why, and I'll start with number four. Number four is about expectation. The stock market moves based on what institutional investors mostly, but as well as individual investors, expect the market to do. So if you expect a company to have great earnings, that means the price of the stock typically is going to go up going into that earnings for each quarter. However, if you expect earnings to be bad, then the stock market will reflect that and the value of an underlying asset will go down. Now, that could change after the actual earnings are put out, but usually even if a company has good earnings or bad earnings, the price of the stock will go up or down based on what people expect it to do over the next quarter or over the next year or 4 years. And institutional investors, which are companies or organizations who invest on the behalf of others, so you can think like a mutual fund or a hedge fund, they have two goals when they're investing in the market. The first goal is to either beat the market, or the second goal is to match what the overall market is going to do. And usually if someone's trying to match the market, they're trying to match an index like the S&P 500 or the total stock market index or a small cap index. And if you're trying to beat the market, then you're trying to beat one of those indexes. And so while the election may play a part in what investments you think may do well over the long term, based on who is actually the president or which party is the president, then yes, that could change your expectation. But whatever expectation most institutional investors have, it's already in place prior to the actual election happening. And so if there is something that they expect to happen based on the change of an election, then they've already prepared for it and it's not going to cause any major drop as far as a stock market crash. And when I say a stock market crash, I mean a drop of 20% or more. Anything below 10% is just regular market movements. Once it gets to about 10%, that's considered a correction. And then anything above 20% is considered a market crash, also known as a bear market. And so based on their expectations, people aren't gonna just completely get out of the market. What they'll most likely do is just rotate into different sector that they think will perform better based on whoever the president is. And so there may be a short-term drop in the market, but it's not gonna be anything major like a 20 or 30% drop or more, just based on who's going to be president next. Now, reason number three is that they have nowhere else to go. Currently, interest rates are pretty much the lowest they've ever been. And so if you have a savings account, you know that the interest rates are super low. There's not much money that you're getting back by holding your money into savings. And because of that, big investors and big even individual investors, they'd rather put their money in the stock market than to put it in a savings account or maybe a bond, because you're going to get more appreciation by putting your money into the stock market versus holding your money in an asset that relies on the Federal Reserve's interest rate. And so until that changes, which the president actually doesn't make a decision on interest rates, then people will continue to invest in the stock market unless there's some big change in the economy where companies aren't making a lot of money because people in general are not spending money in the United States. Now, the second reason is uncertainty. You know what's stronger than whoever the president is? Uncertainty. And we saw that this year with the COVID-19 crisis, where when that hit or when it started to hit the US, there was a lot of uncertainty of how that was going to affect Americans, how bad it was actually going to be for people that actually contract the virus, and whether or not the economy would be able to recover because of the drastic hit on the economy that it took over a short course of a couple of weeks or a couple of months. And you saw that very quickly, the stock market dropped and it had nothing to do with an election. It was all about the uncertainty of a global pandemic. And so that is something that's more likely to cause the market to crash way more than the changing of a president or the president staying the same after the election. And so while depending on who is president, that may cause someone to feel more certain about the future, it doesn't really matter who is going to be president. As long as once we actually know that, okay, a president has been elected, there was no problem as far as counting the votes for the president. Now we have removed some of the uncertainty about what's going to happen. And so while you may have short-term volatility going into the election, a lot of that volatility will be taken away after the election and after we know that whoever is going to be president is going to be president. And then those institutional investors and even individual investors can make their decisions about what they're going to invest in over the next year or the next 4 years. And so the actual election actually brings certainty because we know what's going to happen in the future. A lot of those doom and gloom articles, they'll stop being so prevalent in the news and you won't read about them. And then we'll just go through the rest of the year and going into the new year with whoever was chosen as the president. And now the number one reason why the election won't cause a stock market crash is based on history. History has shown us that no matter who is selected as president, that the economy and the stock market will go along based on the actual economic conditions. While one president could be considered either better or worse for the economy, this does not always play out in the overall market as far as the stock market itself. And this is especially the case in the year following an election. Now, research has shown that the stock market has performed better when there is no change in party as far as who becomes the next president. But it has also shown that based on the performance leading into the election, that was a leading indicator as far as how the stock market was going to do if there was no change in presidency. So taking a look at this screenshot, you see that if there was a positive performance going into the election, research has shown that if there was a positive stock market going into the election, then more than likely whoever was president at the time, whichever party was president, whether it's Republican or Democrat, it usually stayed the same going into the next year. And it didn't matter for the most part if there was a change in the president. As long as there was positive performance in the stock market, typically that meant whatever the current party was for the president at the time, that president usually, or that party usually stayed the same. So of course, if there was a negative correlation with how the stock market was performing, then that means that maybe people in general saw that there needed to be a change in the presidency because the president didn't do what they needed to do to perform well in the stock market, which is kind of a reflection of the economy, but they're not always linked together. And you can see from this chart that when the incumbent party wins, you see the performance prior to the election was usually greater than the performance when there was a change in the incumbent party. And then it was pretty much the same afterwards as well. If the incumbent party won, it usually continued its positive momentum, but if there was a change, it didn't have as much positive momentum going forward. But one thing that is pretty much certain, or that you can see always happen shortly after the election is decided, is that whether it's one day, 1 week, or 1 month after the election is over, there is usually a negative performance in the market. And I see the reason for this is that because of institutional investors' expectations of what companies or what sectors are going to perform well going into the next year or the next 4 years, they're making their changes in the investments that they're in. And so based on what they believe the president will push forward going into the next 4 years, they may either sell stocks that weren't doing well going into the election, or they may take profits in stocks that have done really well going into the election. And that way they can use those proceeds to now rotate into sectors that they believe will perform better over the next 6 to 12 months, or even the next year to 4 years during the next presidency. If we use the history of a positive stock market going into an election, we see that the incumbent party usually wins. And so that means based on history, if we use that as an indicator of who will become president, then more than likely there won't be a change in the current president. But I guess we'll see if that happens or not within the next couple of weeks. And you can see that for the year, the S&P 500 is actually up 6%. We're actually up 25% from the lows of May, because we had a significant drop back in March. And so there was a lot of gains to make up because of that drop due to the coronavirus. And so as of May of 2020, up until today, which is the second week of October, the market is actually up 25%, but it's only up 6% total for the year. And with just a few weeks before the election begins, unless something major happens like a war or a significant increase in infections with COVID-19, then more than likely there won't be a huge shift in the market, whether up or down. And so if you're thinking about making a decision on whether you're going to get started investing or whether or not you're going to sell all of your stock prior to the election, then you shouldn't allow the election to make that decision for you based on the 4 points that I made in this video. History has shown that you shouldn't let an election alone be the reason why you decide to invest or not to invest in the market. It should only be a decision on maybe what sectors you might want to invest in and which sectors may be more advantageous for you to invest in going forward. But even then, there's probably not going to be a huge shift. If you look at the economy as a whole and where companies are going, it's usually going to be based on what those companies believe will make them the most money, or where they think America or the globe as a whole will go towards, whether that's technology or dealing with healthcare or whatever the case may be. The market will decide where it wants to go and where it should go based on the performance and based on the spending of individuals within each economy. But as the saying goes, past performance is not an indicator of future performance. So all we can do is look back at the history to show what has happened in the past. It doesn't guarantee that that's going to be the same for the future. However, if you're dollar cost averaging and you're buying into stocks on a regular basis, whether that's a weekly, bi-weekly, or a monthly basis, then you don't really care about what's going in the market on a day-to-day basis. You stick to your schedule and you're going to end up buying at the high points, and you're going to end up buying at the low points as well. And that way, over time, you're going to average into whatever stock holdings that you have. And especially if you're investing in index funds, it's not going to matter as much to you if you're investing for the long term and you're young and you have many years of investing going forward. However, if you're older and you're going into retirement, then it's a different story for you, because you may be relying on your stock holdings to pay for your future, to pay for your retirement years, and that's your actual income for taking care of your day-to-day expenses. And so you should really take into account your lifestyle and what your expectations are for using the money that you have in the market. If you need to use it in the short term, then you're going to make your decision based on that, and it's not going to be based on the election. And if you're young and you're going to be investing for the next 20 or 30 or maybe even 40 years, then you're not really worried about the stock market crashing. That would actually be a good thing for you, because now you can buy, basically you can buy the same stocks at a discount moving forward. And so if you're new to investing, you should check out my playlist where I talk about investing for beginners. I go over a lot of the basic concepts that you need to know when investing in the stock market. I go over basic definitions, and I also do tutorials of different investment platforms so I can show you how to use those platforms and how to make things easy for you for investing. Now, one of my favorite investment apps is the M1 Finance app. The reason is that you can automatically invest. You can set up automatic investments every week or every 2 weeks or every month. That way, you're dollar cost averaging into the stock market, which is the best way to go for those who want to invest in the easiest way possible and not have to know every in and out of every company that they invest in. They're just investing for the long term, because as we know, the stock market for the most part is always going to go up. My goal is to help as many people as I can to get started with investing and to show you how easy it is to get started with investing. And you can make investing as easy or as hard as you want it to. You can start with just investing in index funds, or if you want to get deeper into it, then you can invest in individual stocks. But for the most part, if you're investing in index funds, that's the best way to go if you don't have a lot of knowledge or if you don't want to learn a lot about how to invest in an individual stock. In fact, if you haven't started investing and you're looking for an easy way to automate your investing, check out the M1 Finance app, which is one of my favorite investment apps. It allows you to invest in the stock market on a regular basis, and you can invest using fractional shares, meaning you can invest as little as $1 per company that you're invested in. And so no matter the price of the individual stock, whether it's an Amazon where the stock price is over $3,000, all you need is just $1 to get started investing with a company like Amazon, even though the share price is significantly higher than that. And also there's no fee. And how about an even lower barrier of entry? How about some free stock? If you use my referral link with the Webull app, you will receive a free share of stock when you deposit at least $100 into your Webull account as soon as you sign up. And you don't actually have to make any trades to receive that free stock. You just have to make that minimum deposit of $100 and you will receive a free stock from Webull. And so I have referral links to both of those apps available below in the description, as well as links to other apps, as well as links to the reviews that I've done of M1 Finance, of Webull, and the many other investment apps that I review on this channel. So be sure to check out those tutorials as well as the review videos that I've made for those platforms. Thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I really appreciate it. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.